So the next interesting sorting algorithm that we'll learn of is called the merge sort, right? So we'll learn why it is called the merge sort, how does it work, everything in this, in the next few videos. But before we go there, the big question here is, why learn another sorting algorithm? Why learn another sorting algorithm, right? Because we already have learned a sorting algorithm. We've already learned about insertion sort, right? So given an array, now I can sort using insertion sort. The big question, the big why is, why should I learn another sorting algorithm? There are a couple of very interesting reasons. The first thing is, if you look at insertion sort, it's worst case time complexity. Its worst case time complexity is order of n square. Of course, its best case time complexity is order of n. Completely agreed, which is very good. But it still has some instances where it would need order of n square time. Now, the big question here is there some other sorting algorithm that can bring this down? Imagine a sorting algorithm, whatever it is, which has the worst case sorting complexity also being, let's say, n into log of n. Let me write it down here. Let's say the worst case time complexity is n into log n. Let's say, we don't know if such an algorithm exists yet. Okay. So let there be a sorting algorithm whose worst case time complexity is order of log n. Isn't this better? Because we know, we have learned when we learned about complexities, that if I have an algorithm which is n square, which has an order of n square, this is going to be slower than an algorithm that is order of n log n. Right? Because n log n grows much slower than n square asymptotically, or in other words, as n increases, your n square will increase much faster than n into log n. Right? So in a nutshell, if I can come up with an algorithm whose worst case time complexity is order of n log n, this is big O. I'm only going to use big O's from now on, unless I say otherwise. So if I just say order of, I mean big O. Okay? So if there is an algorithm which is order of n log n, that is certainly better than insertion sort. Because as the size of my input increases, this new algorithm is going to be faster in the worst case than my insertion sort. Right? So we will show that merge sort will show across multiple videos in this chapter that merge sort's worst case time complexity is n log n. Which means in the worst case, merge sort is going to be faster than insertion sort as the size of your array increases. That's one reason to learn merge sort. There is a second reason to learn merge sort, right? We will learn a new concept called divide and conquer algorithms. So we will learn a new concept called divide and conquer strategy or algorithms, right? So this is a very interesting strategy when you have to design solutions to real world problems. Okay, I'll explain you what divide and conquer and how merge sort is a divide and conquer algorithm, right? But this is in general, this is like a tool. This is like a tool or a technique or a strategy that you have at your disposal. See, remember, we are solving a very simple problem of sorting. In the real world, you'll have to solve many, many, many complex problems in data, using data structures and algorithms. One of the tools or techniques or strategies which is extremely powerful in the real world is called the divide and conquer strategy, right? We will introduce this strategy through merge sort, okay? We'll see this strategy being applied in many, many places across various algorithms and data structures. But we'll first introduce this concept. You have to learn the concept somewhere, right? Before you learn how to apply it. So we will learn the concept of divide and conquer through merge sort, right? There are also other applications which I cannot explain right now. For example, if you have a very, very large array, let's say, that doesn't fit into your RAM. Let's assume it doesn't fit into your RAM. It has to be stored in your hard disk, in your disk, whether it's a hard disk or a solid state disk. In such a case, merge sort can work miracles. Merge sort can work better than insertion sort and many other sorting algorithms, right? So we'll come to this concept at the end of this chapter. But the three important reasons why we should learn merge sort is because from a computational time complexity perspective, merge sort has a better worst case performance than insertion sort. And I'll derive and I'll explain all of that, right? But before we go into it, the big question is why learn this concept? Second is we'll learn a very interesting strategy called divide and conquer, very useful. And we will also show how if you have large amount of data that does not fit into a RAM, right? Imagine if I have an array which is, let's say, 8 GB in size, but I have only 2 GB RAM. If I have only 2 GB RAM, but my array size is 8 GB, how do I now sort this 8 GB of data, right? That can be done using merge sort. It's much, much harder, much more complex to do it in using insertion sort or other sorting algorithms, right? So we'll see all of them. Here I'm just giving an overview of why study, but we'll go through each of these three reasons step by step as we progress through this chapter.